So hey guys, it's Vijay from HP Games. Today we will discuss about another great laptop GPU 1050 mobile version and comparison with its new competitor MX150. And before we begin, if you like the content, hit that like button and remember to subscribe for more awesome videos like this. So the GTX 10 series mobile GPU, the 1050 and the Ti version is launched back on October 2016. 1050 comes with 2GB of GDDR5 memory. It can support up to 4GB of VRAM, whereas MX150 can only support 2GB of GDDR5 memory. MX150 is a laptop version of 10 series GPU derived from the same desktop GPU GT1030 by Nvidia. You can check out the video about MX150. You will get that on card appearing on top right corner of your screen, and I will provide the link in the description section too. GTX 1050 packs 3.3 billion transistors in a tiny 135mm square die and offers 640 CUDA cores, where MX150 comes with 384 CUDA cores, nearly half of the GTX 1050. CUDA stands for Compound Unified Device Architecture. It's a technology developed by Nvidia. It leverages the GPU in a specific way to perform tasks with greater performance. CUDA cores are parallel processors just like your CPU, but CPU are dual or quad core devices, whereas Nvidia GPU host several hundreds or thousands of cores to perform game graphics calculations. One interesting part is MX150 comes with slightly higher clock speed than 1050. It runs on 1468 boosted up to 1532 clock speed, whereas 1050 comes with clock speed of 1354 with turbo up to 1493. Power consumption for 1050 GPU is 45 Watt, whereas MX150 draws 13 Watt only. So you need a powerful SMPS to run this GPU with all hardwares. 1050 and MX150 both are 10 series GPU and developed using Pascal architecture with 14 nanometer chips. As we all know that Pascal was Nvidia's greatest achievement in the past decade, the company's latest GPU system took gaming performance to the next level with the help of this revolutionary architecture. So you will get amazing performance out of both the GPUs. 1050 is packed with some of the amazing technologies, like it's having DirectX 12 and Nvidia G-Sync support. I have already explained this G-Sync technology. You will get the video on card section about now. Simultaneous multi-projection and multi-monitor support. It's a technology by Nvidia which enables you to play games on multiple monitors without losing the texture quality of 3D objects. But sadly, it does not meet the minimum spec of both the Oculus Rift and the HTC Vive, so you cannot play VR-enabled games on it. Few more important stuffs, I will provide those in the description section for you to study. I got few benchmark results of 1050 and MX150 GPU for you. You cut my heart in a million pieces. Damn, why you gotta be so heartless? Why you gotta be so heartless? You cut my heart in a million pieces. Damn, why you gotta be so heartless? Why you gotta be so heartless? You got me like So the results are very clear that 1050 gives you a good performance boost over MX150. Both are 2GB GDDR5 memory version. 1050 performs more than 25% better than MX150, sometimes over 50%. But at the same time, if you consider battery life, then 1050 is a killer one for power consumption with 45 watt. For low power consumption with 30 watt, only the MX150 is a clear winner, which makes MX150 an ideal for notebooks, especially thin and light ones. But you can consider 1050 because it nicely handles 1080p resolution gaming and very efficient and budget friendly GPU. You can say it's a cheaper version of the GTX 950. I got these results by researching multiple websites and YouTube, so system wise results may vary a bit. Requesting all of you to comment me below what FPS you were getting on both GPUs to help other users to get more accurate results. So if you are considering to buy a gaming laptop, then I will prefer you to go with 1050 equipped laptops. No doubt you have to pay little more than budget laptops like 70 to 80 thousand. But it will definitely perform very well on gaming and graphics related works like media editing and all. It's not like MX150 is anyways performing very less than 1050, but as you all know that gaming market is growing like anything. Each new game comes with very high demanding graphics, so to perform well and to play games at least for next 2 years, you can consider 1050 GPU enabled laptops. I have listed a few of the laptops with 1050 GPU. I will provide the link in the description section too. So that's it for now guys, hope you enjoyed and learned something new today. Hit that like button and subscribe for more awesome stuffs like this. Thanks for watching.